Jacob Zuma is the Thanos of South Africa. He won.
Thanos literally won. Thanos killed half of the earth.
And Jacob Zuma took half of your wealth.
Your parents didn't do enough.
Whoa, why are we attacking poor parents yet?
You're having prime area, people looking for prime in the area. Come on.
Fuck New Zealand, actually. They're taking our farmers. Fuck them. So,
y'all don't want them.
What do you mean we don't want them? We want them. It's just we're not offering what New Zealand's offering.
How are you treating your...
Who?
Are they white? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Knox and Maruby Unfiltered. I'm Knox, this is Maruby.
My God.
Dog, I don't have nothing, dog. I was thinking of what I can do.
If people knew the amount of effort that we had to put in to just be able to do this show. And then it's just like, oh my God. Anyways, we could literally get into it. By the way, Knox had these nice things for you guys. Like he had like content for you guys. He had the amount of people that were living and all this. But anyways, it's fine.
It's all gone.
Yes, it's all gone. Dates. Yeah, but we can get into it. We can start with quick fire. Duduzane Zuma, former President Jacob Zuma's son, Duduzane Zuma, 40, has urged old people to voluntarily.
Old people is all people.
Okay.
Old people's lives matter.
Okay. Yeah. He has urged old people to voluntarily step aside to make way for the youth to take over the country in the next year's general elections. Your thoughts, Knox.
What do you mean? It's your thoughts. These are your thoughts.
Yeah, your thoughts. I'm going to give my thoughts.
On, who cares? Who gives a damn? Come on. Who cares about Zanu Duma running?
This guy.
Yeah, you liked him.
I used to love him. I used to love him so much. I used to think that this guy is...
I'll tell you this. I was baffled by your...
My change of heart.
By your... That you didn't know that you...
No. I didn't know about the Gupta thing.
You saw a picture with him and the Gupta.
And I was like, whoa. I didn't know. Yeah, no. I honestly didn't know.
For some reason, you thought he hated his father.
Yeah, I thought...
You lived under a rock.
I really thought, yes. I really thought... The one thing that I did know was the case.
That's the case.
Yeah, I knew the case. And I was like, okay, but... We can forgive people, right? Yeah. Like, yeah.
And then
I saw the Guptas and I was like, no, fuck this shit.
You didn't know that him and his father are close.
I didn't know. But anyways, because he grew up in Mozambique.
It doesn't matter. But no, the thing is, I was just shocked for me to find out from you to say, Knox, I saw a picture with Duduzane.
I'm out.
I'm like, what are you talking? I'm like,
okay. I'm out. No, I'm out. I'm off the bandwagon. Duduzane Zuma, you're not my president. That's for sure. Musi's still my president. I'll still stand by Musi. The thing is, Musi... I'm asking nicely. Musi, you need to join the ANC. That's all I'm asking for.
It's not happening.
I know it's very unlikely, but you need to do it.
It's never going to happen.
It needs to happen, Knox. We don't have a choice. We need you to be president, and no one else is going to be president anytime soon.
Don't you want
to
be president?
Yeah, well, apparently people who want power should not be put in power, so I guess I'm disqualified
Are you going to take over?
No, I'm not a dictator.
You might take over and be a dictator and just slaughter.
Thanos, Ruby, baby people. By the way,
yes.
Your Thanos nigga sucks. Your Thanos nigga.
Oh my God.
He failed to have just a simple thought. Ask for more, not less.
No, that's all. The world only gives you.
Why?
You only have one world and one world only.
So you could have asked for more abundance. Yes.
Yeah.
What?
It didn't exist. I guess Thanos asked. I guess Thanos knows way more.
About what? Us.
Come on, isn't he a god? Is he a god?
No, he's not a god. He's actually not a god.
He beat gods. He was beating gods, dog.
Who? Yeah. Oh, Thor.
Thor kicked his ass. No, he didn't.
Yes, he did.
Where?
In literally dating.
Which one?
Your one, Infinity War.
No, he won.
Yeah.
What happened? He won. So how?
He
how
did literally used the time stone. Thor was kicking his ass. Thor was killing him. Yeah, Thor put it. He put the lighting. What was it? The new blade one that he had.
He gave you a false reality. And you were like,
a false reality.
Yeah, like, I'm beating Thanos.
No, he actually beat Thanos. No, it's just he didn't cut off his head.
No, and he was like, oh. Thanos, my boy.
Yo, he actually was.
Thanos is the GOAT.
He's not.
He's the GOAT.
We're not doing this again.
Avengers robbed Thanos for some reason.
What?
They don't like, go. Whoever's writing this Marvel Marvel movies these days.
These days, yes.
That movie was the first one where a villain actually won at the end.
Obviously,
we knew it was coming.
No.
Is there a movie where a villain won and the movie ended? Do you know of any movie? Even Joker doesn't win. They make Batman a hero. Bane doesn't win, you know.
Bane won because Batman died, technically.
Then what happened? Did he won? No, but Thanos won one. Like, people were crying. I mean, these pathetic people. Why are they crying? Leaving movies. What's wrong? People watching movies. And if it's a real space.
A villain won. Like a villain won.
You see how Thanos won?
Yeah.
Like, he said, I'm going to do this, and he gets it. And we were like, oh, it happened. Everyone was like, oh, it happened.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Anyways, moving on. Duduzane Zuma, you're not the villain that wins in this situation, please.
Him and Thanos, we can't compare that. That's
he's dead and Thanos. He's dead and Thanos. He won.
We can't even put a headline Thanos.
Jacob Zuma is the Thanos of South Africa. He won.
Thanos.
He literally won.
Thanos killed half of the earth.
And Jacob Zuma took half of your wealth.
No, I didn't.
Yes, he did. 500 billion is just... Oh, no. Okay.
He's not.
He's the Thanos.
He's not cool while doing the
what? Cast. Everyone. Cool. Literally everyone. Everyone thinks that this nigga is the GOAT.
Thanos of South Africa.
I mean, you know what? You remember I used to call him the greatest president that we ever had. Ironically so. Because he showed us what a bad president looks
while
like.
While doing the crime.
Nigga, I'm telling you. Thanos, it's like the craziest thing
Thanos
ever.
He's killing people while looking up, saying...
Jacob Zuma.
saying stuff. He have quotes for days, doesn't he? Zuma and Thanos.
You remember
Zuma's Thanos.
Exactly. Zuma is Thanos.
Of the money, because he wasn't killed.
Yeah, so he didn't, to be fair. Zuma, yeah, Zuma
Thanos of the money.
Yeah, pretty much. And then, moving on from Duduzane Zuma, we've got Logan Paul and KSI bringing Prime to South Africa. I heard my brother complaining about it. He says it tastes like water, but it costs 40 rand. LMX. LMX was like, nah.
Did he drink it? Or
No. But he's like, this thing probably tastes like water.
It's just another thing.
Yo, I'm just happy that people in these kids... The North kids don't have to pay 400 rand anymore. They can play 10% of that, and it's all good.
They
could afford it, but it's exploitation. What about the kid that's... Can I tell you something? The kid that... I'm thinking about the kid that's peer pressured by the kids from the North. Knox, you're a kid. What do you mean it's on you?
You guys here. You guys here in the North.
Who's in the North?
No, I'm just saying you guys in the... Peer pressured.
Don't say you guys.
I've been being peer pressured.
Did you have access?
What do you mean?
Access. Yeah, did you have... Exactly. No. That's why you wouldn't get peer pressure.
No, the thing is, people will have stuff, at my street. And I'll be like, I don't have it.
Okay.
Dog, I just moved on with my life.
Yeah, that's all. That's you, Knox. A lot of kids out there have peer pressure.
Can I tell my story? At least peer pressure, of so-called peer pressure not affecting me on anything. So people will have, marbles. You see marbles?
Yeah.
Because I'm from Ekas, playing marbles.
Yes.
people have marbles, you know. I'll go out on a beautiful Tuesday morning, or Saturday morning.
Okay.
People are, you know, playing marbles and stuff. You know, I didn't have one. Just stood there. Like, oh, I don't have a marble.
Okay. Well, what's your story then here? Where are you going with this?
Then people were playing and it was a whole thing. Guess what?
One.
Just stood there. Like, I don't have one. I'm just going to go home.
Okay, where are you going with this?
I'm just saying, just go home. Just don't buy your damn Prime. Go home.
Okay.
Go flipping home.
Either way, shout out to Checkers.
Peer pressure. Peer pressure into
Knock, stop bullying people. You're being a bully.
These kids must learn. Go home. You don't have it.
Okay.
You don't have it.
What would you like to say to these kids? Go like one phrase, say it to these kids.
Go home, you bum. You don't have access.
Bam.
Yeah, bam. Okay, not okay. Bam. Okay, your parents didn't do enough.
Oh, whoa, whoa.
Yeah, they didn't do enough.
Whoa, why are we attacking poor parents here?
You having dog prime area, people looking for prime in the area. Come on.
Uncle Waffles, Coachella.
My girl is crushing it.
Can you repeat that so people can hear that?
It. Yes. Y'all are hating on Uncle Waffles, and Uncle Waffles is crushing it. Y'all thought she would be out of here. By now, look at her now, shining.
I was one of them.
Hey, Uncle Waffles can DJ. Uncle Waffles getting lessons to DJ right now. Y'all can't stop Uncle Waffles. She's cool. She's cooler than 99% of y'all.
Come on.
Coachella main stage.
Devin Gogo.
Main stage.
Think she's cooler than Devin Gogo?
She's cooler than all the female DJ. Okay, maybe
Devin Gogo.
DJ's in his way. Maybe DJ's in there because I don't know.
Because you're a fan of DJs and Clay also.
I love Devin Gogo as well.
Okay.
And she can now DJ. Because I told you that thing you called him in.
Who? Lives at the Villain. Lives
at the Villain.
Knox. Look, it's cool. I get it. You love Uncle Waffles.
Crush them. Out here with Sierra doing the dance. Come on now.
Well done to her with the Coachella thing. Well done.
Main stage.
Congratulations.
Main stage, by the way.
Main stage, yes. That's huge. Maybe one day she headlines when she can actually DJ.
Stop hating on Uncle Waffles. I'm playing.
Actually, you know what? I'm going to scold myself. Marping, that was so unnecessary. You didn't have to do that shit. That was so unnecessary. That just shows a lot of jealousy.
Apologize.
I love you, Uncle Waffles. I love all of you. Sorry for comparing all of you. I love you all. Anyways, moving on.
That's weak.
What do you mean?
Choose a side.
I choose a side in which I'm empowering women.
You. Oh, you think you had a comeback? You think you had a comeback? Look at this guy. Anyway, move on with your fake.
Yo, hey, people, I think I'm misogynistic. Look, I'm just saying.
Let's move on. Think positive you're going to say.
Yeah, there's generally nothing.
Ended with your fake love.
Yeah. Oh, today's all sports.
Those are not all the topics.
What? We have more. What? What do you have?
Oh, that's it.
Yeah, that's it. We had load shedding, but I don't want to talk about that bullshit.
Thank God.
That's some bullshit. That's just a mess.
Uh-huh.
What? Technical difficulties again.
Technical difficulties.
Okay.
No, nothing important. Nothing important in this podcast.
Is it the madam?
No, it's an email.
Knox, why don't you date this girl?
Okay, let's move on. Let's go.
Yeah. Knox. Like generally speaking, wait. Can we address this? Wait. Can I tell people your situation first?
No.
Why not?
I'm not discussing my personal affairs on the podcast.
No, it's not like that. It's not like your personal affairs.
Let's do the Premier League.
Okay, she's not going to watch this.
We're moving on. You know
that you're hiding this thing from her.
We're moving on.
Knox, come on.
No, I'm not doing it.
Please, no. Anyone who gets this far in the podcast, please hound Knox to please tell us his story. Mm-hmm. Because right now, to give us permission to speak about his story, because it's a really good story.
I genuinely don't
understand it. Maybe you guys can help me understand
it. It'll be fake here and fake everywhere. But anyway,
okay.
What?
We're starting with the EPL?
Yeah, that's what we're doing.
Whew, okay, EPL.
I mean, come on.
Yeah.
Okay, let's talk about the big one first.
Which is Liverpool catching up to Newcastle.
I mean, come on. But yet, dog.
Knox.
I don't know what to say.
Knox, I told you, Liverpool is.
It's not.
The third best team in the world right now.
You were giving examples about, we're beating everyone There's, above us.
No, generally.
We beat you this year, by the way.
Let's oh, everyone that. Underneath, Joe.
Oh, so what?
Everyone underneath. So I don't know. There's only one team that beat us. That's above us. Two, technically. Arsenal beat us when they were playing home. And
beat y'all.
Joe, Brighton, it's just a nightmare.
Come on.
But anyways, Liverpool's the best, third best.
Ah, come on, Knox, look at this. Come
Knox,
on.
Knox.
This is a
Knox.
Come on.
Knox.
Look at this.
Knox. Knox, you know that Liverpool's the third best team in the world. You know.
Look at this.
No, I'm not even going to debate it
look
with
at
you.
The results.
Knox.
You're not.
Liverpool's the third best team in the world.
Why?
What do you mean, why?
You gave a reason. You were like, on our best
okay.
day. Look at you.
If you take us on our best day.
Look at this.
And you match us up with any other team on their best day.
It doesn't count. Look.
We are a better team than every other team besides Real Madrid and Manchester City.
You went to penalties with Derby County, dog.
Look so what? Knox, that was... What cup is that?
EFL Cup. I don't even know what it is.
Okay. And? What that?
Not Forest.
Knox.
Ruben, this is not the best.
Knox,
this is not the third best team in the
we
world.
We are the third best team in the world when we are at our best.
Yeah, come on, people can just say that. When I'm at my best.
Let me ask you this. Uh-huh. Is Bayern better than us?
Yes.
Ah, you lying. Because yesterday you were literally saying Bayern's not better than us. Ruben, okay. You literally said this.
No, I didn't say
yes,
that.
You did. Yesterday you said.
Okay. Whoa. Before you continue, on our best day.
Can I ask you this? Uh-huh. If we catch up to Newcastle, If we catch up to them, will you admit that we're the third best team in the world?
No, you're just not. Look at this. Look at the results. Look at the results.
Knox.
The results.
I am saying, you know this was a bad.
Nottingham Forest.
Knox, but you know this was a bad season.
Nottingham.
But you really know that this was a bad season.
So you're not the third best team in the world.
What do you mean?
Terrible. You're terrible.
We are a top three team in the world
you're
right now, Knox.
No, you're just terrible. Look at the result.
Knox, let me ask you this, right?
Ask.
Name better teams than us.
Nottingham Forest.
That's not a better team. You know it's not a better team. Just because you lost to them doesn't mean you're not a better team than them.
You were giving me this example yesterday. Oh, yeah.
Saying what?
Oh, you were like, oh no, we're beating all the teams above us. Name a team.
It was.
I'm like, oh, so what happens now? The team that you beat.
Knox, because all the teams that we no
them.
Wait, uh-huh. All the teams that were playing that were above us, uh-huh. We actually you saw the best of us. You saw us playing against Arsenal.
You won. No,
what do you mean? Because we won? Because I've seen won. Shit let's, games. Let's, no, let's I've just, seen us playing
let's
shit
see,
games.
Let's see the lineup for the Brentford. Well, let's see who was playing, and you give me the assessment if. If you all were...
Thiago had a horrible season,
okay.
Right? Uh-huh. Salah had a horrible season according to his standards. According to his standards. Oxlade-Chamberlain, non-factor.
Okay.
We know that Oxlade-Chamberlain's uh-huh. non-factor.
Okay.
Davin Nunes.
Van Dijk.
I love Davin Nunes, but he's a disappointment. Let's be honest. Van Dijk had the worst season of his life. Fabinho... None. Only just came back now in terms of form.
Why are we even mentioning this team?
What do you mean?
Look
at this lineup as well, yeah, right? Uh-huh. Trent Alexander-Arnold uh-huh. having a horrible season beginning of the season.
So what
he's only
this?
Picking up now.
Agar,
you want me to show
all
you?
All I'm hearing is excuses.
It's not excuses. You told me to give you the excuses.
No, I'm just asking.
You're the one that told me right now to say, yo, why have you guys
You're terrible, dog. It's a bad team.
Knox?
Except you're not the third best team in the world.
Who's the third best team? Who's better than us? I'm asking you right now. Is PSG better than us?
I'm not going to mention.
Is PSG better than us?
Who watches PSG? Dog, Ruben, you're number 7 in the league.
Is Barcelona better than Liverpool?
Barcelona's number 1 in the Spanish language. What are you talking about?
Is Barcelona better than Liverpool?
Ruben, Liverpool is terrible. Liverpool is not the third best team in the world.
Okay.
We can move on from that.
If it catches up to Newcastle?
I don't care. I don't care what they do. I don't care if Liverpool is just not the best team. It's just the third best team in the world.
I know this may sound delusional to a lot of people.
It is.
But if you really watch football matches, you will see that Liverpool is still at that level.
Liverpool fans, man. Oh, we've had enough of them.
Okay, then.
They didn't do the people of... Is my camera still on?
It's not like... Oh, and you the one that's... And you the one that jumped off your bandwagon of Chelsea and you left to go to Arsenal. And look now. You guys are the reason why Arsenal's not winning the title right now. Yeah, but you guys are the reason why Arsenal's not winning Arsenal's not winning the title because Chelsea fans left Chelsea to go to Arsenal and passed on the bad luck.
Okay, so what does that have to do with us not being the best team in the world? The third best team in the world.
Nah, I'm moving on from that shit. Yeah, I'm saying you have no right to come here and judge me for saying that. You have no right to judge me because my team is even above your team.
Yeah, no, we're terrible. I admit, I'm not. Claiming,
we're not terrible right now.
Claiming anything.
We're not terrible right now.
I'm not claiming any success.
We were.
I'm not even gonna sit there and be delusional and say Chelsea's whatever.
Fuck this shit. Liverpool's the third best team in the world right now. Whoever doesn't believe it,
let's speak about
go tell it to your mama.
Oh my goodness gracious, people's moms getting attacked here.
Yeah,
stop
I.
This
nah.
He's on a rampage. But anyway, let's move on to news that matter.
This team deserved this shit. They deserve this. Tottenham actually deserved this.
Let me play your boy.
They really do deserve this.
You still want to play the clip of your boy?
Eish, you see now, because I've seen it so many times.
You're fired up about your Liverpool.
No, it's not that. I've seen that clip so many times. Uh-huh. But let me not ruin it for people. This was like super hilarious.
You saw it way too many times. I was concerned because you wanted to play it. So I'm like, if he wants to play it, why is he watching it a million times? Watch it once.
Yeah, but it was really funny. That's the thing. What's happening? What happened?
It's Wednesday today.
Yeah. Oh, no, it's not Wednesday. It's Tuesday.
Oh, I saw a message here.
By the way, yeah, Knox has like church on Wednesdays. Yeah.
He was
a bit panicked that he's missing his service.
Close him down. Great save. No! Oh my God, already blood! Already fam! Already blood! Already fam! I'll sack him now, please. Sack him now! Oh my God, sack him now! Get him out! Far, no! I can't be, nah, bruv, you know, nah, fuck this, blood. I'm not reacting. I've had enough. Whatever, 2-0, blood. What's that, free? Oh my, it's free! Oh my God! Oh my God, it's free! It's gone in, blood! Oh my days, bruv! Oh my days, 3-0! Just split in two, save this. Ah, it's 4-0, blood! It's 4-0! 4-0! Philly's done it again, fam! Blood, tell me, blood, please tell me that's not 5. Tell me that was a replay. It's 5! He's got a hat-trick! Yeah! No, I'm not celebrating! No! No! I'm not celebrating! Oh my God! Are you fucking kidding me, blood? Are you fucking kidding me? Oh my fucking days, blood! You prick! 6-1 now! 6, blood! 6, fam! 6, blood! 6, fam! I told you Wilson will come on. Fuck off, man! Fuck off, man!
Oh, I love this guy so much. Shout out to Expressions Ooze. Look, Knox. They deserve this. Fuck this team.
I don't know why you're so
fuck all of them.
Tottenham.
No. Fuck all of them. Genuinely speaking, especially Hugo Lloris and Harry Kane, because they're the ones that are responsible for that locker room. For in terms of players, they're the senior players. The most senior players in that locker room are Harry Kane and Hugo Lloris. Now, for them to perform at that level, and you got rid of two amazing coaches. Right now, Mourinho is killing it at Roma.
Yeah.
Right?
I told you, they don't want to be here.
Knox, Conte, and Mourinho. Uh-huh. Right? These can't speak for Pochettino, though. But Conte and Mourinho, right, have won trophies everywhere else except for Tottenham. That is disgusting, Knox.
They don't want to be there.
doesn't want to be there.
Yeah, yeah.
And the problem is, that means he's a rotten egg. Meaning that when shit goes south, you can't depend on Harry Kane.
Yeah, he should leave.
Yeah, leave. Cool. Whoever's willing to take him, just know that when shit hits the fan, it's going to really stink.
Yeah, but the owner's busy just clinging on to him. I don't know.
Knox, he's a brand. If you heard expressions, this is why I said you should hear expressions. There's more videos, by the way. Mm-hmm. You should go check it out on Barstool Sports and on his, Band Sports? Something like that, right? With Harry Kane, he's a brand.
Okay.
And Daniel Levy understands that. I actually feel bad for Daniel Levy. Having built that stadium, having brought in the amount of, having actually spent the amount of money he spent on transfers just for Tottenham Hotspurs to come and perform like this, Knox. Like this.
They don't know if that's going to be there.
Knox.
Let him go.
Knox, the whole team is built around you. Okay, sharp. Wait, let me. Okay, sorry, I lost my plot. Right, Harry Kane. Mm-hmm. As much as he doesn't want to be there, the reason why Daniel Levy had the need to keep him for so long at Tottenham is because he's an English brand, right? Okay. And he sells, so that's why he needed to do that. Right now, you have a situation in which he had brought back Bale, thinking that Bale may perhaps perform at that level so that he could actually purchase Bale for the next season if Bale had actually gotten to that level. In that way, you could have actually let Harry Kane go because you had Bale, which is the hero of Tottenham.
Yeah.
This is just business. This is just the simplicity of business.
Yeah.
Harry Kane is the face of Tottenham.
Okay.
He is now a disgrace. I know that Tottenham fans will tell me, oh no, you are mad. I am not mad. This nigga has not done shit for you guys this season. It's all, what do they call it in basketball?
He's not a nigga by the way.
Okay. This broer has done shit for them. Mm-hmm. It's called, what do they call it in basketball? When it's like useless goals. It's all of them are pretty much going to shit right now. All those goals that he scored, he's the second highest, the top goal scorer this year.
Yeah.
But all the goals that he scored, they won't matter. They won't contribute to anything.
24 goals.
He's got, imagine, 24 goals and you guys are still fifth. And you are beaten 6-1 by the team that's just above you guys. 6-1, Knox. This is not the same as the United loss. Because the United loss was a shocker. You know that it was a once-in-a-lifetime thing.
Okay.
This does not seem like once-in-a-lifetime.
You think it's going to happen seems over as if, and over?
Yes, it seems as if another team could have come in just done the exact same thing and over and over. And that's what they deserve because they are behaving like children. Tottenham Hotspurs players are behaving like children. They know that they can perform at a much higher level, but they choose not to. Knox, in eight minutes, you are 3-0 down.
They don't want to be there, dog.
Knox, 22 minutes, 5-0.
And the poor guy got fired.
How can he not get fired? And this is imagine, Joe. This guy was the one that took over when Conte was gone.
Yeah.
And they were performing lights out for about 2 to 3 games straight. Right? Conte comes back. These niggas are back at it. They just tanking performances. And you're just like, what? Yeah. What is this? This is not the Tottenham that I was watching.
Conte did Tottenham and then children as well.
Now they have this guy.
Yeah.
And they still behaving like children.
How do these people think? Aren't they adults? Don't they have kids, some of them? Acting childish.
They do.
Acting
Knox.
Childish. We want to fire a coach, so you're going to play bad and tank the season.
That's the thing that I don't understand. Yes. Because you look at Liverpool, right? It's not that.
Yeah, Opa.
Yeah, Opa. It's just. Yeah, it's not going well. Yeah, but with these guys, you can see that they are literally deliberately
just losing.
Yes. Because even when they are being beaten 6-1, I don't see anyone, except for Lloris, poor Lloris though, except for Lloris, who has his head down. That's the only guy that I saw. I was like, okay, this guy is... No one's... You look at Son, Son is just like,
people are adults earning millions of pounds.
Joel!
And they... Are you going to tank a season because you're so unhappy with the management?
They were in full control of qualifying for
Champions League.
At least if not full control, but they had a really good chance of qualifying for Champions League.
Yeah.
Liverpool, who had no chance at all, Knox, is now 3 points behind them with a game in hand and an opportunity to go past them. How pathetic is that?
Yeah.
Liverpool, who have been playing shitty.
Yeah, I guess adults acting like 5-year-olds, you know. It's an expensive adult, you know. An adult that's childish, very expensive. $1 million worth.
One win in the last 5 games in the league, Knox. With a goal difference of what? 7. And you are Tottenham Hotspurs. Your top goal scorer has 24 goals. No, shambles.
Yeah, no, it's terrible. Talking about shambles, let's talk about the Arsenal, which you called... I'll give you credit for this all the time. I'll say this.
I said it.
Called it, said Arsenal ain't winning. Ain't winning the league.
And I'll say it right now again.
Coming back.
I'll say it right now again.
Uh-huh.
Arsenal's not winning this league. They're not. It's just City's trait. This is what they do, Knox. Yeah. If y'all are out here thinking then. If y'all are out here thinking that City is about to lose any game, they're not. These guys just. Go on, they just go on some hectic winning streak. It's just amazing how they can pull it off at the end of the season. Every season, the only place where I'm worried about with regards to City is Champions League. But besides that,
because they're facing Real Madrid.
It's never mind Real Madrid. Well, they're way better than Real Madrid. It's not like Liverpool last year where it was you're scared. Yeah, the thing, can I explain why I say I'm not really worried about them with that regard, right? They just so good. And that kid is just, Boy Wonder is just amazing. Boy Wonder is just lights out, right? Uh-huh. That I'm not worried about. I don't think they have the nerves that Liverpool had last year. And that, who lost to them? Chelsea or City in the semi-final? Last year?
Who? Madrid.
Madrid.
I don't know. Maybe Chelsea.
Chelsea, no?
I don't know.
I don't think.
Where was Rudiger? Was Rudiger at Chelsea?
Yeah, he was at Chelsea. So I don't think
they
have those nerves with regards to Chelsea and Liverpool.
Man City.
Man City this season. I don't think. Yeah, no. They're very confident because they know that they are the best in the world right now. No one is, not even Arsenal, is near them, in my opinion. My opinion.
I can agree on that.
Yes.
That's a very sober thought. I can agree with you on that.
But with regards to Arsenal and winning this league, it's very unlikely. When's the game? Tomorrow evening, no? So, in my opinion, Arsenal's probably going to lose tomorrow.
They're going to bottle it.
They're playing at Etihad. Yeah. The best that they can do is probably a draw. That's still not good for them because if City wins both their games in hand, they're above them.
What happens if Arsenal wins?
Then
you're not shaking a bit.
No, I'm not even shaking because
not even a back sweat.
No, because I know what these guys. City can really chase you down, and they just can.
Are they playing in their next games?
Again? They really put pressure on you. So, the only people who survived it was Liverpool, and that was what, long ago now.
So who? Okay, Arsenal. Okay, let's just say. Draw, maybe, whatever. Fulham, I'm on easy day. West Ham, easy money. Leeds, what are
Fulham's
we,
not easy
what,
money.
What are we doing?
West Ham's not easy
Everton,
money as well.
Come on.
Oh, are we talking about City? Oh, yeah, for no, City,
no,
yeah.
No,
the
no.
only thing, yeah, you'd have a problem with Everton
because
they're fighting for relegation and they're at home. And then you have Chelsea. Yeah.
Oh, my God.
And then you have Chelsea.
Which be a tricky situation.
Yes.
It depends on what's going to happen with them.
But I'm sure Lampard will want to...
No, this is not easy money as well.
But what? Yeah, Brighton's also not easy money. So they've got... Brentford's also not easy money. So the last three games in the league are going to be... very interesting. I'm sure it's like a game July, that they scheduled July, for. Oh, okay. Yeah, but
last game of the season. Oh, it's the final.
Yes, it's the last three games in the league, which is Chelsea,
Brighton, Brentford.
Oh, four actually, including Everton, because Everton's still fighting for survival. Those games are interesting. Fulham could be a cruise. West Ham could be a cruise. Leeds could be a cruise.
Leeds is easy, man.
So
I think these are the games where they're gonna maybe. So they play here, tired Everton.
You see, that's where I look at. But then when you look at Arsenal's fixture,
my goodness gracious,
what's Arsenal's fixture looking like?
Look at this.
Nah.
Oh my God.
But look at the squad. Yeah, you look at the squad and you're just like,
So let's look at the Arsenal.
You have Chelsea, City, Newcastle, Brighton. This is a horrible fixture list. This is the worst way to end. No, Nottingham Forest you can win. Wolves you can win. But these are teams at the bottom all as well, fighting for relegation.
Nottingham Forest just scores one and Brighton.
Brighton's literally looking.
These are tough.
Yes, Brighton wants to qualify for Champions League. Newcastle wants to qualify for Champions League.
Man, these two games here, these are the deciders, dog.
That's the thing. If they can't figure out those two games, I think they can get the Chelsea game. Yeah. But then now it depends on Chelsea and the redemption tour that they may be on. Because I'm looking at Chelsea and I think Chelsea wants to go on a redemption tour.
And I don't think they want to
tank it too much.
I think they're done.
But against big teams, they perform.
No, they're done. Chelsea are done. So
they're
looking for top 10 at best.
Yeah.
They're number 10.
Yeah, no, that's a fact. But then I'm saying, against top teams, Chelsea pulls through. Like, they really put their hearts in it. Unless that team just comes out and blitz them.
I mean, come on. Arsenal here, like these four games here. I mean, this is terrible for Arsenal.
You know what? In my opinion, Knox, I still stick with it. Beat City.
I might have to agree with you, dog.
Yeah,
they're actually just going to tank it. Badly.
And look, I still stand by it. If Arsenal wins the league, I'll go take that 10-kilometer run. Yeah, that's cool. I'll do it.
Is that for the Arsenal?
Did
you do this for the Arsenal?
No, I did it yesterday. It's just yesterday's episode. So I'll still stay by it. Arsenal's not winning this league.
Yeah, it doesn't look like it.
Yeah, this fixture is not designed for them. Man. And the team that's chasing them is just amazing. So, Arsenal's not getting this league.
I mean, this is terrible. But yeah, man. Poor Arsenal.
Yeah.
I feel bad. I didn't know that. Actually.
But it's funny. EPL is still entertaining. And
yeah, because we went to watch.
You still want to see the relegation battle?
I never care about relegation.
No, but this year is pretty interesting considering who's there at the bottom. Look at Leicester. Leicester was nasty.
I don't even care about that.
Leicester's now just out of sight. Look, so...
Man, Everton is getting really...
This is sad. Yes, I really want... I won't lie.
Yeah.
I would choose Leeds.
To what?
To get relegated.
Oh, yeah.
I'll choose Leeds. Uh-huh. I'll choose Nottingham Forest. And I would choose Bournemouth. That would have been my selection.
Southampton can go.
I really like Southampton. I really like the players that they have. I really would have preferred with it, especially how they performed against Arsenal. I was very impressed with that.
Leeds, Everton, who are you? Who do you want more?
I would want Leeds,
Leicester.
Everton.
No, Leicester, Everton.
I would want Leicester.
Oh my God!
I know the reputation is a thing, but I would really want Leicester to stay. They've got the money to compete.
They can go. I'm fine. I'll take.
They've got the money to compete.
I'll take Everton over everyone here.
Leeds is the one that I'd really say should go. I just
like Everton in the. In the thingy, dog.
Yeah,
Leicester at least was there. At least you can.
Switch if I were to keep one team and take out one team. Obviously, it would be Everton for Leeds. I would really keep everyone else.
Man, this is terrible, Everton.
Mm.
Lampard did this.
What Lampard? Yeah. No, it's not Lampard.
Oh,
actually,
it's him.
No, these teams. No. These players, Everton players. That's why I'm telling you right now. If it was between Leicester and Everton, I'd take Leicester.
No, I'm saying it was Everton.
No, it's the players. I was telling you about that fucking Iwobi. Jesus, Iwobi, Knox. You are a top 10 player. in this team, right? Yeah. Definitely probably the top five best players. Okay. But you hardly run, Joe. Like, you're not even putting in the effort to run. You look at Onana, the way Iwobi is such a senior player that Onana knows that Iwobi is playing like shit, but Onana can't even shout at this nigga. And Onana's the best player there.
Yeah, he had his first games were terrible.
Bro. Who?
Onana's first.
No, I can't. But then he got grips to the Premier League, and eventually
he got Lampard fired.
Who?
Onana.
No, he was performing for Lampard. Oh, what are you talking about? What Everton games were you watching?
The first one, the one where Onana was terrible.
I'm talking about towards the end of Lampard's tenure, right? Onana was his best player. Him and Idrissa Gana Guye, those were his best players because you could actually see them running up and down. Unfortunately, what the mistake that Lampard made was he wasn't playing Idris.
I was actually shocked to find out Onana is actually playing well.
He was playing really lights out.
I know him from the other team he came from, that he was very, very good. Then he comes in the Premier League. I'm like, what's going on with this bro? Is he even... now he's performing.
If we were ever looking for a replacement at Liverpool for Fabinho, I definitely one of the names that I would bring up was Onana. Yes.
All right, man. All right, that's the Premier League.
Yeah.
Talking about replacements, you know, we're looking for a team that's gonna replace the GOATs, you know. I think Sundowns should just
I don't want to talk about
if that can happen, like no, oh, I can talk about it.
Yeah, these niggas is, no.
So they should move to another. They should. Yeah. I don't know if there's a possibility for them to move to another league and play there.
Do you know what's sad?
Because this is
Do you know what's sad? Yeah. I feel like they're unfair.
What are you talking
about? Like I know that there's nothing wrong that they did.
Yeah.
But I feel like they so unfair. Like it's wrong. What they're doing is wrong for some reason. But there's no. They're so good, Knox. Like, they can play at a European level. That's how good they are. They're blitzing everyone in Africa. Everyone. Your best team. Al Ahly saw
through them. I mean, nothing.
Nothing.
I mean, it was nothing.
It was mesmerizing. Al Ahly looked like it was what? What's last in the Premier League right now? In the PSL? What's last? Maritzburg. No, wait. Why is Maritzburg last? Oh my God, this is wrong.
Oh, Gallant is out.
What? Oh, shout out Gallant. I can't hate on that. Shout out to them.
Yeah, but come on.
Anyways, but Sundowns, I don't want to talk about them because it's wrong. What they're doing is wrong. It's so unfair. I genuinely, and it's not like they went out and bought the best players in the country. No. Some of half of the team is their development.
That's so good.
And
Goats?
They've got,
we should get
of this era. Yeah.
They took it though.
Yeah, this era.
The guys in Soweto, I mean, these are...
I wish they had a better marketing team. But that yellow doesn't help them, though.
The Brazilians?
Yeah, that yellow doesn't help.
Oh, yellow.
Yeah, yellow. Like, that yellow is not marketable. Like,
isn't Matip's son just out here killing
it? No, with regards to managing this team and how it's run, he's killing it. But with regards to, they should have a fan base which is now very competitive with the Kaizer Chiefs and the Pirates of this world, but they don't.
The thing about the Pirates and Chiefs thing is like, everyone is just going, Sundowns thing is a fluke, but it's been a fluke for what now, 6 seasons?
No, no one's saying it's a fluke anymore.
No, I'm just saying, like,
everyone's looking at it and saying, well,
hoping and praying.
There's a cheat in some form of way, somewhere, and all of us don't know what it is, and I don't think it's just a well-run club with enough experience to take on whatever competition that they need to.
They're serious about football,
and they actually
take care of the football.
Yes, they really actually pursued like this glory, and they actually achieved it. And if anyone doesn't believe that they're the best in this era,
I think they're truly mistaken. They're probably getting a second star.
This season. Oh, definitely. No one in the CAF Champions League looks like they even close to the level that they're playing at.
They're playing so well.
I'm done talking about them. You can carry on, Knox. You can carry on complimenting.
I just want to give them their flowers.
Yeah.
Let's go to the two teams in the in Soweto.
Okay.
Your boy Arthur Zwane.
Okay. Look, you know my thoughts with Arthur Zwane. I will express them though.
Not a big fan of Arthur Zwane, this man.
Most people are not sure. Yes. But I called it from game one. I said, this is wrong. This is not the right person.
You don't know why they fired. Oh, you know now.
Now I know. And it's still shit, right? Yeah. Arthur Zwane is not the guy that's going to lead us to where we want to be. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, I will commend him with, before our recent loss, right? Okay. I will commend him and say that he was playing the right squad.
Yeah.
And he actually performed really well. Okay. Yes. Yeah. And his substitutions were on point. Do you remember there was a time where I was complaining, why is he taking out the... Now he's on point. He's doing the right thing. Yeah. I think with this game, he wanted to give other people a chance to play with this Kukuna game. Yes. It was unfortunate that everything transpired the way that it did.
Yeah.
But
you feel bad for him.
I don't. I think it was just a tactical move. It didn't matter to him, really.
We lost the game.
Yeah, it was just...
It's not a, he must go.
Yeah, No. I do think, though, they should be thinking of a replacement for him. Possibly a Dr. Kumalo. You know, I've been an advocate for that. I know. But you've got Pirates
Look at this. We are CT out here.
Yeah, that's why I was telling you yesterday that I would have preferred a NetBank Cup final of Pirates versus Sundowns ahead of everything else.
Pirates is on a run, dog.
Yeah, so
I didn't know this actually.
Yeah, you guys are the most informed team. You guys are really playing well.
Dog, the guy said the coach said I'm not losing any game in the second leg.
He's not losing any game.
On a bender.
Yeah, I mean, he's got the best player in the country right now.
Hey, you and this best player.
Who's better than him?
No, I'm just saying.
Who?
Man, you love him way too. I don't know. You love him way
because
too.
I saw him one game.
Yeah.
I watched him one game. I just knew that this guy is the best player in the league right now.
Okay.
Name who's better than him?
No, I'm not gonna name.
Besides Sundowns,
I
told you they cheated. They don't count. Yeah, they don't count.
Yeah, but I don't know. But
who's better than him right now?
No.
In the league.
Yeah, he's good. I'm not gonna argue that thing.
And honestly, I'm not gonna hit the table today.
Yeah.
Bafana.
Yeah, they should also get,
I swear.
They should get that defense. So that Pirates
and defense. That Pirates defense is actually the best defense in the country.
And not the keeper, though.
And by the way, what you guys did to Yusuf Mart was some bullshit. Bafana needs to sort themselves out. You've got players that are playing in the country at a high level. You do not do that to them.
You put them on the sideline.
You do not do that to them.
Yeah, that was bad.
You really need to play our players. Because that's at an international level. The Percy Tau's of this world, right? They've made it. Okay. And he does deserve to play. The Foster does probably deserve to play. Okay. But you've got Krobler, who's playing lights out right now.
He's really putting in the scoring.
No, you can check. I think he's behind Shaolil. Yeah, see, 10 goals. Yeah, look. Literally look at this. Yes, look at this. Saleng, Krobler. These are players which are playing at a high level and they're not even getting game time for Bafana. This is embarrassing, Knox. We are not Nigeria. We've got a good league in this country. It's at least decent. I'm not saying it's English Premier League because, wow.
They're playing in the English.
It's nowhere near that, but...
They're playing in like...
Knox.
Like I said, maybe they should... try other leagues, maybe, because are they competing against the best of the best?
Knox, I look at it at this level, at this way, right? Uh-huh. Even though you are not going to start him,
uh-huh,
you better give him some regular minutes. He's not supposed to sit the whole game. No, this is the best player in the league,
okay,
in your league. He's not supposed to. He needs the exposure, Knox. Okay. You, as the international coach, knowing very well that I can win this game, give him the exposure. Never mind that. You know what? Play him. Because I... Who's playing left wing for Bafana Bafana? Can you go to Bafana Bafana squad?
I haven't watched Bafana Bafana in forever.
Generally speaking, he's better than Foster. Sorry, he is better than Foster. Saleng right now is better than Foster. Saleng right now is arguably much more in form than Percy Tau. Form. Not saying he's better than Tau. I'm saying Tau is the best player at Bafana Bafana.
You don't watch. The thing is, I know you're speaking.
No, I was watching the game.
I know you're speaking out of your
I was watching the Liberia game. It was pathetic, by the way, that you couldn't even penetrate through that defense.
I'm just saying, like, you're speaking out of your ass because you don't watch these players at their league.
What do you mean?
So you don't know whether they're better than
Knox.
Like, I'm not gonna.
Let's go look at Percy Tau's stats right now.
I'm looking for the final squad, man. I'm looking for the final squad versus what? Liberia.
Yes.
I'm looking for this team.
Yeah.
Which one is it? The first one or the second? We lost to Liberia.
Nonsense is this? When we won. No, it's not that one.
We never won.
We did win. Oh, we won 2-1. Two one.
How can we qualify?
Mm-hmm. So.
Oh, is the Mayambela kid?
From Sundowns.
No, he plays for.
Fuck it's not that Sundown. Shit. No. No, no, no. I'm tired of these European young niggas coming in. No, 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 no. No. He's better than that Mayembele kid. Morena, which Morena is this? Sundowns Morena. He's better than Morena. No. No.
Oh, no, yeah.
Yeah, no, 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 no. Saleng's better than Morena. No. Saleng, how old is Saleng right now?
Saleng, he's...
You played Le Pasa ahead of Saleng.
No, but he's not a striker, I guess. Saleng. So you can't play him up there. He's 20.
Knox is 25. One.
Yeah, he's 25.
No, okay. We're not getting into that.
Yeah.
No, yeah, we're not generally not doing that.
Munapule Saleng is 25.
Yeah, we're not doing that. But honestly speaking, Munapule Saleng right now is the best player playing in our league outside of Sundowns players.
When I'm looking at this squad, he should play.
Yes.
When I'm looking at this.
Yeah.
He should be here. Morena. I don't, because the thing is, I don't know how good Morena's playing.
Knox.
The thing is, I don't know. I don't watch. So
Knox.
I only watch Pirates, dog. You know me. I only watch Orlando Pirates.
Knox.
That's my team.
You watch Chiefs as well, so.
That's bad. I don't know. I'm not committing to Chiefs.
But like, you do watch often.
If I'm somewhere in the world and Pirates is playing, you better believe
this team couldn't penetrate through that defense.
We won 2-0 though.
2-1.
No, let's see. 2-1. Let's see the first squad of that first
game. When was this?
Because they played like back to back, something like that. Foster played.
I don't. You see, if you're gonna do this, right? Temba's won. Foster. And
are you happy with this?
I'm. Yeah, but who's that?
I think it's the. I don't know.
MLS! No, man! No, man! What are you doing? No, Knox! No, 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 no. No. Ah, oh, I already dwelling. No, I already dwelling.
No,
no, no. Who's our coach, well?
Oh, the white guy.
Nah, sack him, fam.
No, 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 no.
Sack
no,
him
no,
now.
No, 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 no.
Wait, is he a white guy?
Yeah, Hugo Bros.
Oh, they fired that nigga.
He's good.
They fired that nigga. There was that nigga before the Bruce.
The black guy.
Yeah, that black guy.
Yeah.
Fuck that nigga. Guy. Yes, yes. Nah, yeah. Sorry, Bruce.
This is Hugo Bruce.
Sorry, Bruce. Sorry, my bad. No, no, my bad, my bad, my bad, my bad.
Not taking bribes.
What? Hugo Bruce is not. Oh, okay. Yeah. No, no, no. My bad, my bad, my bad.
He's not taking bribes to like lunches with.
Yeah, no.
Agents and all.
Yeah, no.
Like a,
yeah, no, no, no.
Our guy.
My bad, my bad.
Imagine
my bad on that.
We just think Hugo Bruce is our guy because he's not taking bribes. This is the lowest form of just.
Knox, I'm telling you now.
He's very good. I think. It's
yeah, no. Well done to him for landing the job. Fuck that nigga before him. Nah.
That's too harsh.
Nah. Knox, because I'm looking. He's the way that he wanted to do it. For instance, I've always said this. Temba Zwane is the best player in South Africa, right?
Okay.
Temba Zwane, I still think Temba Zwane is better than Saleng. You obviously believe otherwise.
Yeah, obviously.
Right?
Exactly. Yeah, but I'm not even trying to get into this because.
Yes.
It's not
so, in my opinion, the thing is, you can't even tell me who's the best player in the country.
But it's not them. That's the thing. It's not just.
Who is it?
I don't know. It's not.
If it's not Saleng, if it's not
Saleng can be in the in the circle with all of them.
Who's them? Who's them?
No, I have the best players inside. It's not just I'm not giving it to Tembazwani.
Anyways, I've always said Zwane's the best player. I'm okay with that squad. That first squad, the one that drew 2-2, I'm actually very happy with it. I don't know what's going on at the back.
Okay.
Tolkis, BC, need to really think about that. That's a really good center back pairing in the country.
I think they took
Tolkis, I think. You can't play Kulu, man. No, man.
They took Sibisi.
You can't play...
Tolkis was injured.
Yeah, you can't play Sibisi ahead of Dede Angcho. You can't play Kulu ahead of Sibisi. No.
Toby Mvala.
No.
Azerbaijan.
They just not at that level right now, Knox.
Wait, in Azerbaijan?
No, him. He's not at that level right now. This guy has just really got good agents and can really sell himself. Because Kulu's not it.
They should just play Sibisi at Kroki.
Yeah.
And just close up.
Honestly speaking.
Come on. You don't like this guy. But
who?
You. Do you like him? Are you the guy that doesn't like Williams?
This is what I hate about Ronan Williams. Okay. Ryan, he's looked at as if he's generational. And he's not really generational.
No, he's not a cool name.
Yeah, he's not at that level in which I would say he's at... Not even Monib Joseph level.
Yeah, because I would debate that.
But to be honest, let's all be honest. Kun is the best keeper that we've ever had. You guys are just hating.
Football or whatever. And
yeah, no.
It was Kun and Monib in most of the
league. Yes, but no, guys. Kun is the best.
No, I agree.
Yeah. Probably Brian Baloyi was second to Kuna. And
you, but I told you, in all of
yeah, Akran. But let's be honest. It was Knox.
They put Munib.
Akran.
I didn't even know.
No, I'm not denying that.
I'm saying,
mm-hmm. I'm really with you. Because we actually agreed on it. We're like, whoa, we all agreed Mansoor Kuna is the best that we've ever had.
Like, I mean,
and all of a sudden now.
Even the presenters, like, I thought this was a one and done thing. Like, Kun is the best
thing
we've done, but people are like, nah.
Yeah, no, so it's very shocking.
They're like, Munib. I was like, Munib? I was like, oh, I don't know Munib.
Yeah. But anyways, yeah. What do you think? I don't want to actually speak about South Africa State, but Nedbank specifically.
Okay.
That whole situation in which they had to force Chiefs and Pirates to actually play earlier than...
Yeah,
because of so what do you think of it's practically saying what do you think of South African state this football state
no what
the state
I
of South African
what do
football
I think about Chiefs and Pirates state I think that's
because that is technically and as much as people don't want to admit it, Chiefs and Pirates are the state of South African football.
So
yes,
for you not to have the confidence to put them on the side,
yes.
I know it was a draw.
Yes, no, it's not. It's,
you,
guys,
I'm just
all
saying,
of them are rigged.
For you not to put them on the side and say, let's meet at the final, it just shows you where they are and they are footballing. Like, you don't have the confidence because they could lose to Skukun at any time.
I mean, in a situation like Kaizer Chiefs, you can lose to
I think Pirates Skukun
and Stellenbosch. Pirates...
Can scrape because we scraped away against like Dondol or Dondol.
You've been scraping actually your last Nedbank Cup fixtures. We've been scraping them.
I think there would be conflict.
It's the Chiefs.
Pirates.
Yeah, it's the Chiefs' problem because you're really not sure with Chiefs. And I'm telling you, the reason why we can't beat small teams is because
he's giving them chances.
No, it's because of just coaching.
Okay,
we don't have. Great coaching. And we fired two great coaches. Do you understand that?
Kevin Hunt and thing.
And Stuart Baxter. That's that's elite coaches. Not just...
He's second now, Kevin Hunt.
Yeah. Look at him now. He has the last laugh. You understand what I mean? Mm-hmm. So, you look at the situation and... Yeah. It's
not the best. But yeah, dog. Anyway, man. But Pirates, Chiefs... Who's winning? Oh, I want you to give you a chance to pick a winner. You said Chiefs.
I would really go with...
I'm saying, because Chiefs went on a bend on Pirates, dog. I mean, just beat them all the games.
No, I think this time around, Pirates can get it done. We both know that Pirates is the better team. We both can admit that.
Yeah, but Chiefs keeps on winning the games. So it's like, I guess parents are just sitting there going, hopefully we convert. But
okay.
They're not converting their chances.
Having seen how we won our last game against Pirates,
yeah,
and really, if anyone who's a real true supporter of football, mm-hmm, we were playing better than you. That is true. No, yeah, we did play better than you guys.
Last four derbies.
But it looked like a draw. It didn't look like it was something in which... And right now, in terms of form, mm-hmm, both teams are on form, besides this blip in Chiefs'...
going on a bender, dog.
No, yeah, besides the blip in Chiefs', Chiefs is really on form.
Chiefs has like... Where's the PSL table? But Chiefs has like a... Let's see your guys' run in the PSL. So, all right. Draw and a lose.
Yeah, no, Chiefs is playing well. Chiefs is actually, it has a really good... We are, funny enough, I was not happy with the squad, but I'm really happy with the squad now. Because it has a lot of depth. And if you use it right with the proper coaching, like I said, you could actually get results. I was very happy with Cole Alexander playing this weekend. I was really happy to see him back. That's good. We have a squad that can...
Just needs to be utilized very well.
Yes. And I don't know. You can give Zwane time, mm-hmm, to develop. You can sort of do what Arteta did. But I don't believe he has the brilliance that Arteta has. Me again called it. Arteta's a great coach. Look at him now.
I think I'm not taking from you.
What do you mean?
You hating on Arteta, dog.
When?
100%. Because before even the season started.
What?
You were like, but before you were saying, you were like, Arsenal is going to win the league, Vel. I remember you saying.
Yeah.
And this is what you were.
No, I was like that.
You were like, it doesn't look good. What are you talking about?
I'm not hating on Arteta. I think Arteta is still a great coach.
You came in and you were like, I told you Arteta is the coach. But when they start winning, you go, they're winning.
No, because all of... No. Everyone started jumping on Arteta's dick. And I was like, fuck that shit. No, y'all are out here.
What is this?
No, when I was saying, everyone was calling for Arteta. Everyone I was saying... Every time everyone was saying Arteta should get fired, I was like, no, you guys don't know what you're talking about. This guy is a great coach. You guys don't understand. Then now everyone wants to jump on his dick now. Nah, nigga, you don't get to jump on his dick now. You're supposed to jump when I was jumping. And now look at the situation that you're in. You ain't gonna win the league. Marpeg's... Yo, no. Listen to this nigga. You need to listen to this nigga.
Why? Because you were like, Arteta. Then when people are favoring him, you go.
Listen to me now.
You go.
I am telling you now.
I'm just saying. You were happy to go on Arteta when people are not on Arteta.
No. I wasn't going on Arteta because people went on Arteta. I was on Arteta because I knew that Arteta was a great coach.
So
yes.
Kick Maruby, great brilliance of Maruby. That's fine. I'm all well.
Like I said.
The problem is when you go, they're going to win the league. They should. What's this guy doing? What's going on?
Knox, I remember when we lost to Arsenal.
Okay.
The first game. I think we lost 3-2 to Arsenal.
Okay.
In the first game. And I remember sitting down and looking at this squad and saying, this squad is, they play decent, but it's a top four, top five finish, not a win the league.
Yeah.
Then I missed half of Arsenal season. Then when I'm like, whoa,
they were like 8 points.
Yeah, I'm like, nah. Yeah. But now look, I was right. I made the right call.
You're not making a call. You were not approving of Arsenal winning.
Yes, and I said they won't win the league.
Yeah, you didn't say that at the time.
Yeah, I was just hating.
They shouldn't win.
Then I started watching them. Then I was like, no, this team's not winning the league.
That's fine. It is the thing of you going, they shouldn't win. Like, it's a, No. No.
Yeah, Knox. No. Knox, yeah, no, it didn't. The thing is, it didn't add up.
It wasn't
even them finishing second. I would literally actually root for United to actually chase them down. But then, obviously, that's not going to happen.
I don't get it, but yeah. Anyway.
With Chiefs, though, with regards to our future, we can next year compete. You can keep Arthur's one, but you'd have to keep the core of your squad. The squad that, the first team. So the defense, you'd have to improve on maybe getting a center back.
Okay.
I don't know. Hlanti looks good, but he's getting old, so I'm not sure about that one.
You've got who?
Gonja, who's that kid? Left back and right back. Who's that kid? Frostler. Can you go to the squad that we play?
The one you played now with
him. Yeah.
Who are you playing?
Nice, Kukun.
Kukune United.
I really like Hlanti. Hlanti played well against Pirates. He really did kill it. Frostler and Solomon. Solomon just needs a little more development, but he'll be a good player.
Okay.
And then with the midfield, Mart obviously solid.
Yeah.
You're going to have to bring back Kondo, what's his name? Shabalala's nephew, man. Scroll down. Maybe he was on the bench. I'm not sure.
Shabalala's nephew.
Yeah. He was injured, that means.
The guy with the dreads.
Yes.
The other guy. Is this
Chabalala's
nephew, man?
Apparently, he's related to Chabalala in some form of it. Why am I forgetting his name? I'm a Zulu kid. And then you'd also have to go back and play Shabalala.
Who's
Vilagas? Vilagas. No. That's Vilagas. Vilagas.
Is he playing for
Chiefs? Yes.
What?
Yes. Yeah, I'm sure he's coming back from injury.
He's playing for Chiefs?
Yeah. No, he's coming back from injury, I'm sure. So, you see, but then now up front, you've got
he's playing for.
Oh.
Kuku, no, it's not Chi. Oh,
wait, we're looking at.
Oh,
okay, Schota. No, it's not Schota. Schota is just the kid that I like.
Oh, I thought it was Schota.
Yeah, no, it's not Schota. I'm sure he's injured.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Because
oh, he's not playing for Chiefs. No, I thought he was playing for Chiefs. Actually, that would have been a good signing for the Chiefs, actually.
Nah, I think he's no longer Villegas, you know.
But you've got, you see, so Dupree, Saile, yeah, Dolly's injured now, so I don't know what we're going to do.
Ooh.
With regards to how, out bringing Schotter, you know, I've always emphasized on developing.
Not the goat, Bermany Miyanga.
We have Matoa still on our books.
He still plays.
Mm-mm.
He plays. He plays in the Black Label Cup thing.
Because
they always select. They love Matoa.
Yeah, but yeah, yeah. I'd really play with regards to Schotter. You know, Schotter is very. He can create chances, but just finishing is the.
Is the problem.
Is the problem, but he's a really good player. I would love to see Dupree and Schotter, and Saile. As our front three in the future, because they're all young, and that's a front three in which I'd keep if I was Chiefs, and yeah, this Chiefs' future could be bright with the right coach, and I don't know, Zwan could be, because Zwan looks good with the kids. You understand what I mean?
They like him.
Yeah, but for us winning titles,
it's not good.
I don't know. We could win the Nedbank Cup. I think Chiefs are the favorites to win the Nedbank Cup.
Okay, I don't.
Even though I do think they'll probably lose against Pirates.
I don't think they're the favorites, but
I look at them as the favorites because I think we've got your number. Every time we play you guys, it's
like the Pirates thing. I'm like, they can beat Pirates. That's fine.
It's Stellenbosch and Cocoon.
Those two teams that where they just come in and you're like, what's going on? What's Chiefs doing?
So I do think they can pull it off. I really do.
Talking about things being pulled off, do you think our boy can pull it off on the 9th of July? Oh my God, this is terrible. This is
the worst thing that could have happened to Du Plessis, actually.
We woke up to like sad news.
Yeah, this wasn't good news for us.
We went to the title straight at least.
And yeah, this...
Oh man,
we I you know, I'm gonna stay out of it with regards to I'm actually Knox. I have decided.
Nah.
I've decided because either way it's a win-win for me.
You don't care. Here's the thing: Maruby wants to get out of this thing now because his boy is fighting our South African, our pride and joy. And we had it.
That is my pride and joy as well.
We discussed this.
That is my pride and joy.
Yeah, listen, I'm an easy fan. I'm a down to earth easy fan. And we were like, look, if ever our boy fights easy, I mean, I'm not even an easy fan at this point. I'm a Dricus Du Plessis fan. This is South Africa. He insulted our boy.
Who?
Easy. He said he'll drag his carcass across South Africa.
Oh, okay.
And I was like, I'm your fan, but I'm Dricus's fan. Because we were like, nah.
Ish,
I love Knox. Easy, but we have a South African fighter fighting. We're going to support him through and through. And we wake up at 12 o'clock, midnight, 1 o'clock, 1 a.m. We watch this man fight.
Yes, we do.
Now they're forgiving him. I mean, this is the best fighter in the middleweight.
Who? Robert Whittaker. Yeah.
Easy just has his number.
Yes. Easy knows how to beat Robert Whittaker.
Whittaker beats everyone.
Everyone else. And it's not even close. The way that he does it, it's really...
He beats them better than Adesanya.
Yes, yes.
But Easy just has his number.
And
they give Dricus the best guy in the middleweight.
Robert Whittaker is the best middleweight fighter in the UFC
right now.
Yeah,
he is.
And Dricus Du Plessis was unfortunate to get this number. I was really, as soon as, and here's the crazy part. As soon as they announced Cannoneer, Vettori, because it was like a few days before. Yeah. I was like, this is bad.
Oh, when they announced that, I was like, Dricus is getting the belt.
No.
Because I'm like,
I knew that was going to happen because they needed to figure out Robert Whittaker, because Robert Whittaker's been saying, I want to fight, but everyone was ducking him.
The thing is, Dana said, Easy wants to fight now in summer.
Yes.
Summer is now in America.
In July, yes.
And I'm like, he wants to fight now in
He's
summer.
He's probably going to fight the light heavyweight title.
Yeah, but I was thinking, he wants to fight now in summer. Mm. And he's, because I saw the banter between, a young banter.
Yes.
And Dricus.
Yes.
With the nose thing. I'm like, Easy's even
making fun of Dricus,
this is definitely happening. They announced they just announced.
The thing is, they want Easy to go to Australia. Well, they wanted the Australia
this
fight.
It's a setup fight, by the way.
Yeah.
I need to say it now. Yeah. The winner takes on Easy in Australia. This is where Robert Whittaker is from. They just want Whittaker.
No, it's not that. No, it's not that. I'll explain why.
Just make it an
I'll explain why it's not that. They wanted New Zealand for Easy. New Zealand just has so many restrictions with regards to COVID and all that stuff. I don't know who the... fuck New Zealand, actually. They're taking our farmers. Fuck them. So...
don't want them.
What do you mean we don't want them? We want them. It's just we're not offering what New Zealand's offering.
How are you treating your...
Who?
Are they white?
Yeah.
Yeah, how are you treating them?
What do you mean?
Oh, Jacinda Ardern is out.
Oh, okay.
So whoever this guy is.
Yeah, but I guess the UFC is punishing them for how they were treating them during COVID and everything.
Okay.
And with Australia...
Come on, Bruin. Come on. Don't be sheep. Come on,
what do you mean sheep?
Nah, you know what the UFC is doing.
No, I don't think the UFC wants to... Izzy is the brand of the UFC. Izzy is the face of UFC.
This is a setup fight for our boy.
For Dricus,
But Izzy, dog.
No, yeah.
Him... The fight going to Australia, I was like, so Dana, even the judges, even if our boy wins a close one, the thing is winning. Robert Whittaker is winning. This is a setup.
What?
Fight.
No, this is not in Australia. This is at Las Vegas.
Let's make this a shot. Dricus Du Plessis. Knock out Whittaker because they're going to rob you, son. If you take this to the judges and it's close, they're going to rob you, boy. Win the fight by a knockout or something spectacular.
Let me ask you something.
Set up fight. Australia.
Let me ask you something.
From Australia. Yeah.
Do you think he can do it?
Dricus Du Plessis, you can win against Robert Whittaker. I believe in you, son. And you must win. Knock him out.
Yo,
knock him out.
Knocks. Look.
When he has to win. He has to win. Dricus has to win, dog.
Look, I love you, Dricus. I will lie. I do love you. I understand your situation. And I always say, I wish that the UFC actually slowed you down more than accelerate you at the rate that they did. Oh, yeah. Like, right now, you should be at the level of fighting Sean Strickland instead of fighting Robert Whittaker. Because then you would have gotten to the title maybe when they were either old or just retired. But now you at that level in which now they're at their prime and they really look good. Yeah. Like, they really, really look good.
And our dog, this is just a disaster, isn't it? Oh, man. Camping Simon is still far. Okay. And it's not a guarantee that he's going to. Because Dricus is here now.
I look at Simons good. And I think he will be one of the best. Yeah, they will start accelerating.
That's fine.
Dricus had the belt. Yeah. And he had the amount of fights. Like, yeah, Dricus's record is 19-2. Yeah. So when he went into the UFC, he was like, what, 15-2? Like, so he was 14-2. Yeah, so 14-2. Yeah. That's huge with regards to him being able to be accelerated.
The thing with Dricus is that he's here now. We're not sure if the Cameron Simon is going to make it here. The thing is, Dricus is here now.
Yes.
We want him in there.
Now.
But the problem is, you know, when you get closer and closer to the top and you're just seeing these kids.
Because we've been panicked ever since the fight before. Before. Who's this guy? Yeah, before Brunson. Ever since the fight before Brunson.
Every time he fights, though, our hearts are just in our...
Yes. So, after the surgery, even though he has more oxygen, we don't know whether or not he's going to perform better or not.
The problem is that Whittaker's not dropping off. It's not a bum.
Yes.
Whittaker's not becoming a bum.
He's not tired if he doesn't get tired.
Whittaker's still very good.
He's one of the best in the middleweight ever. Like, ever. It's not even dating. Ever. Even Bisping is like, no, this guy is better than me. And Bisping was a really good fighter. So...
he's not getting tired, dog. He fought for the belt twice. Come on, move on.
No, the thing is, he wants... You see how Izzy... wanted
Izzy had to get that boy.
Yeah, the same way Whittaker wants Izzy.
The thing is, he had to get Pereira like that. There's no other way Izzy wins that fight other than
yes. So that's
the only way for
that's how Robert Whittaker wants it. Because when you remember that last that last fight uh-huh. that they had, Whittaker won.
But here's the thing: if you want the belt, you don't win like that.
Yeah, you
like
see.
If it was easy performing like that, yes, he still wins.
He wins. Yeah, yes.
If Whittaker has the belt,
he still wins. Yes, he wins. He wins. Yes.
That fight,
You don't win the belt like that. Whittaker looks back at that fight and says, "I won." You see, he's not coming out.
Knows. He knows that's not how you win the
fight. He's not coming out saying, nah, y'all rob me.
And against Izzy as well, who's just, come on.
You see, Volkanovski has a situation that's similar to Whittaker, although he did put on a better performance.
I think the.
I don't think he won, but it was.
I was shocked to see that people were actually picking Volk.
Picking Volk over Islam.
I'm like, oh. Because people called it for Volk.
But I do think it's a bit of bias with regards to lovability and everything and the immortalness and the underdog and all that. So everyone would have loved to see that story. Because the guys, imagine Islam loses. Everyone now calls for who? Everyone starts calling. No, I'm just saying that would have been the narrative. I'm not saying Khabib was going to come back.
The only time Khabib is coming back if
Connor beats Islam. That you'll see Khabib will be like that. You'll be like that. That's the only time.
Coming back, dog.
Yeah,
that's gonna be the biggest selling pay per view
ever.
If
ahead of any Mayweather pay per view. Islam. Oh, and they're like, Lord.
Dana, make it happen.
That would be the biggest thing ever. Yeah, Dana, go. Even if you have to pay like 200 million each, you're going to make the money.
Must take a dive.
I love Islam. So, I really like Islam.
Imagine Conor goes there, beats him, gets the belt, goes, where is your brother, whatever. Oh, my goodness gracious.
So, yeah.
Khabib goes on Twitter, I'm back.
That would be amazing. But
yeah,
with regards to Dricus Du Plessis, Robert Whittaker, I will not jump off the bandwagon.
Nah, you are, dog. You've already done it. So I don't feel your energy anymore. Dog, you duped. I'm no longer going on things with you. I'm no longer going on the ride with you.
No, look, nah, you know what? This is the worst thing that could have happened.
It's done.
Yeah.
You are rooting for Robert.
I'm not. No, I'm not. I'm genuinely not. Whoever wins this fight, I'm rooting for them against Dating.
It doesn't work.
I'm neutral, Knox. Nah. You won't see me celebrate. Do you know what? I will celebrate if Dricus wins. But if he loses, I won't celebrate.
These neutral people.
I won't celebrate.
Be pushed off cliff. What's wrong with you? Choose a side. What's wrong with you?
Knox, Shem. This is just, it was very saddening. I look at this fight and I am sad. I knew it was coming, but I was not. That's why I didn't say anything. Like, I didn't keep on saying it. I was like, it shouldn't happen. Then it happened.
Your energies work towards our boy Dricus. You know me. Do you know how I feel? I'm with Dricus against Adesanya, dog. Like, my heart is just going, Dricus Du Plessis.
I hear you.
My heart is just all in. You,
I hear you.
Fake fan.
The thing is, no. The fake thing is, South African, yeah, fan. Wait, let me explain. No. Let me explain. And you know this very well.
No, I don't care.
You know Robert Whittaker is one of my goats.
I don't care.
You know.
Who's my goat?
Nah, he's not one of your goats.
Easy's my goat.
Nah, he's not.
I love Easy to bits.
Nah, you love him, but he's not one of your goats. You don't look at him and be like, yeah, this is the end and beyond.
No.
I look at Whittaker and I'm like, this is the end and beyond. I've told you before that Whittaker's better than Adesanya. And you're like, nah. And I stood my ground to show you how much love I had. But you can't say that for Joe. If I'm like, yo, Jon Jones, Adesanya is better.
Whoa, this guy. Jeez, man. Talk about comparing, what is it? Cheese, chalk and cheese. What's wrong
What
with
do you
you
mean chalk and cheese? It's the MMA fighters, are they not? And they've beef before. So what do you mean chalk and cheese?
Ruben, that's Jon Jones.
Okay.
Ruben.
You see, I would have stood my ground. I've never heard Whittaker say that. Nah, I can beat that bro. I've never heard Whittaker say that. Adesanya said it though.
That's Jon Jones, 23-year-old, beating Shogun Rua, who was arguably the goat of the sport.
Okay.
I mean, just beat him up. I mean, just 23
years. Yeah, no, I'm not denying that. I know that Jon Jones is the goat.
Jon Jones.
But if I was like,
what?
I would stand my ground.
Khabib,
I would,
what?
What? What do you mean, Khabib?
Well,
what?
No, say.
No, Khabib is a better grappler.
Say more words. Than who?
Than Jon Jones.
Ruben.
What do you mean it doesn't matter? Khabib at heavyweight. Let me ask you. Khabib at heavyweight.
Listen to me.
Khabib at heavyweight.
Listen to me.
Khabib at heavyweight.
Listen.
Okay.
Khabib goes, I'm going to fight Jon Jones.
Mm.
Let me tell you something. Khabib is going to try and take Jon Jones down. Let me tell you
something. Khabib at heavyweight.
Let me tell you what's going to happen. They're going to beat the shit out of him. Jon Jones is going to be like, oh, you're going to take me down.
He is. And he's going to get it done.
Never.
Knox, you're telling me Khabib at heavyweight.
Jones. I don't care how big. That's Jon Jones.
Knox.
Jon Jones.
Khabib at heavyweight is the goat of MMA.
I don't care.
Khabib at heavyweight. If Khabib was a heavyweight fighter, Khabib would have been the goat of the UFC and MMA all round.
Jon Jones chooses a sport.
Knox,
he's the best.
Khabib would have been the goat of MMA.
Sir, you are talking out of your ass.
Okay. If Khabib was at MMA, Khabib becomes the GOAT.
Stop talking right now because you are... My respect for you is... Doing
Knox,
this.
Khabib at heavyweight would have been better than Jon Jones. Stop. And I will say this over and over for whoever wants to hear it. Khabib at heavyweight would have been better than Jon Jones.
Sir, you are spewing nonsense.
It is not nonsense. Khabib at heavyweight would have been better than Jon Jones. Knox, I don't care how many title defenses that Jon Jones has, how many championship fights he has. No one was going to be better than that guy. That guy was just phenomenal. Can I ask you this? Can I ask you this? Can I ask you this?
What are you asking? What are you doing?
Did it look like anyone would have beaten him?
I don't care.
No, I'm asking.
He's better than Jon Jones.
I'm not saying he's better than him now. I'm saying if he was a heavyweight fighter.
I don't care. He's not beating Jon Jones.
Jon Jones has had fights in which it looked like he lost.
Who was he fighting?
What do you mean? Dominic Reyes. Dominic Reyes.
He wasn't motivated.
Both know that Dominic Reyes won that fight.
Yeah, I know. But then? Come on. This guy's comparing Khabib to Jon. I mean, talk about the disrespect.
Disrespect?
At the biggest level.
Disrespect? What do you mean disrespect? You're the one that's disrespecting Khabib right now.
Oh my God. This guy is spewing nonsense, man. So let's move on to other things where we can all agree on, because oh my God, this guy said words which my ears can't take anymore. But anyway, the GOAT did it. The face of boxing, the man, the myth, the legend.
Is he the face of boxing? He's not the face of boxing.
Tyson Fury's the face of boxing.
Yeah, he still is, but unfortunately.
Tyson Fury's a bum. I still stand by that. He's ducking that guy. This kid is not ducking anyone. Love this kid, dog. He just goes up. They told Ryan Garcia. Oh, I saw Ryan Garcia now is going. Oh, I'm going to do a rematch, whatever.
Is he?
Yeah.
Is he doing that?
Yeah, he did that.
But he wasn't supposed to do it.
Yeah, he did the.
No, the thing is, what he said is maybe one day down the line, maybe we can meet,
but he's not going.
I was fine with that statement, but now if he's saying a rematch...
No, not a rematch now, obviously. No, obviously. He's not talking about anything now.
Okay.
But he's saying he can...
What?
...beat this man.
No.
He made I made mistakes. I ran
into his
spot.
No.
Hey, he caught me.
No. He's just way too... Yeah, he's way smarter than you. Like, he's a much more... He has a higher IQ in terms of boxing. Tank is... I didn't believe it. This was my first fight watching Tank, and the hype is real.
Told you.
The hype is real. He's...
6'7", 8", he gets you, though. He's either... Oh, by the way, he said that he's going to get him on the seventh round.
He said
round 7,
that knockdown was...
People are saying Ryan Garcia should have got up. And I'm like, liver shot, come on. That's a terrible... Because people were saying... I heard Shannon. He was talking about how Muhammad Ali and Joe Frazier... because that was a thriller in Manila where they both went to the hospital after the fight. It was just bad. So they were saying... He should have just stood up. Because they were saying he was looking at Ryan Garcia going, I saw what you had to offer. I don't want any of it. So I'm going to just put it on me. Oh, well, I think he was saying, stand up, go on another knee. I don't know how that works.
And
who's this guy? Cejudo was saying he should have stood up and went on another knee. I don't know if that...
Does work, yes.
So, yeah,
but then the ref can still end the fight.
So that's what Cejudo was saying. He was saying, take another knee. And he just did this. But yeah, man, guys, thank you for listening, watching, subscribing, and liking our videos on the pod. I'm Knox, this is Maruby. Peace out. This is Knox and Maruby Unfiltered.
Is that the song you want?